Okay, this is it. You're ready to start making beautiful things with paper until you try to cut a straight line with scissors and you ruin your expensive, beautiful paper. Hey, thanks for hanging out with me. My name is Amy England, and welcome to Scrap This, Save That, a channel designed to teach you the basics of paper crafting. In this video, I want to introduce you to the Tonic Studios Guillotine Paper Trimmer and show you why it's one of my all-time favorite tools. So let's take a little tour first. There's this plastic guard to hold down your paper and keep your fingers safe, and there is a crazy sharp blade that's self-sharpening every single time you use it. On the bottom of the trimmer is the handle and the cutting guide, both neatly tucked away. This makes it more convenient to store away when you're not using it or if you want to travel with it. To install the handle, you just line up the tabs and insert the handle so that it won't be rolling around while you're using it. Once it's lined up and pushed firmly in place, it's installed and ready to go. The cutting guide has a little kickstand to keep the trimmer level once it's installed. There's a little hole, as you can see, that just pushes right into there. And then once it snaps in place, put the little kickstand down and it's ready to use. When you're ready to store it again, you can squeeze it, pull it back out, and it pops right back out just as easy as it went in. I'm cutting a few panels for the project I'm going to do that are going to be 5.5 by 4.25 inches each. Just slip the paper underneath the guide, hold it down so that the paper won't move, and just chop to your heart's content. I think I only used 2 panels in here, but I cut some extra ones for some other projects later. This trimmer is great for using up paper scraps since you can cut such tiny little bitty strips. I have a bright rainbow of assortment of scraps I found that I'm going to play with. Looking closely at the cutting guide, you can see that the increments go all the way down to 1/16 of an inch. For this project, I'm using 1/4 inch strips, so I just take my first piece of scrap, start at a 1/4 inch mark, and then cut the little end piece off, and then just chop, 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 1/4 inch all the way till I'm done with the paper, or until I've had enough of the little pieces for each color that I want to use. I know I want to do multiple projects, so I'm just going to keep cutting little strips until I have a nice pile of each color. Once I get done with the red, I'll just start in with the next one. I was only able to invest in 1 guillotine trimmer, so I decided to get one that would be the smallest for my desk, but where I could still cut 12 by 12 pieces of paper since I'm also a scrapbooker. So this one, I can put a 12-inch piece in, and then the guide goes all the way to 12 inches. So I can take a whole scrapbook piece of paper and do whatever I need to do with it. There's lots of different brands, sizes, and types of guillotine trimmers. I know Tonic Studios also makes the Tim Holtz brand, but there's lots of other ones out there on the market too. They're not cheap. They're definitely not a cheap paper trimmer, but they're definitely worth it. The cheaper paper trimmers are just going to give you some cuts that maybe aren't quite as sharp and as straight, and it'll be harder to do these little tiny 1/4 inch cuts like what I'm doing now. As I'm finishing up the scrap paper that I'm cutting, I take each color and make sure and keep it in a separate little pile. Since I want to go in actual rainbow order, it's going to make it a lot easier that way when I start. I'm grabbing those white panels I cut earlier, and I'm going to put some super strong double-sided adhesive tape on one side. I have a big 5-inch roll, so it'll cover most of the panel with just one piece. You can do lots of fun things with this kind of tape, and I'll be sure to show more in future videos. The tape will cover most of the panel, and then I'll just cut off the rest. This tape is awesome for pretty much any project where you need some really, really strong adhesive. It's great to stick glitters down and all kinds of other things too. I can line both panels up on the tape and then use a ruler and a sharp blade to make clean cuts to separate them. Then I'm going to use my Teflon bone folder, another favorite tool of mine, to burnish the tape into the paper really well. This tape has the name Sukwang, and I hope I'm saying that right, printed on the back of the backer paper. But I know lots of other companies like Scorpal and Elizabeth Craft Design also license this tape and sells it from their shops too. Now comes the fun part. I made piles of each color of my paper strips, and once I peel off the backing on my adhesive, I'll start laying the strips down in rainbow order. This one I'm going to do diagonally, and then I have another one a little bit later that I'm going to do just, well, I guess vertically, because it's going to be in a vertical position. When I get to a point where the strips are too short to cover the paper diagonally, I can just use some of the pieces that I'm gonna trim off here in a minute and then go back and then kind of paper piece them together. You won't really even know unless you look close up that there's going to be a seam in the paper. And since I'm gonna die cut this panel, and that's gonna be coming in the next video, so stay tuned, you won't see the seams on the strips. I have a few more little pieces here, and then I'm just gonna use my scissors and turn over the piece of white cardstock, and then just follow the lines of the cardstock as I'm trimming. And that way it'll be nice and even, and since I'm using it to die cut, you're not gonna notice it anyway. Once I get these last few pieces down, I'm gonna turn over my paper again and use my scissors and just trim off the excess. Then I'm gonna take my Teflon bone folder and I'm gonna really burnish everything in nice and good. Love my Teflon bone folder. I'm doing the same thing on my second panel, but just placing the strips straight across this time so I won't have any seams. And I'm just gonna keep going in rainbow order. Actually, I guess I'm kind of doing reverse rainbow order this time. All comes out the same though. In the very next video that I'm gonna put out after this one, I'm going to talk about very beginning basic die cutting. I'm gonna die cut a word and put the word on here and use this card panel as kind of a background. So make sure and keep an eye out for that video. It should be coming within the next week or so. Once I've finished with all of my strips, I'm gonna take my bone folder once again, get it nice and good and burnished in, and then I'm gonna go back to my guillotine trimmer and trim off all those little edge pieces. This way my edges are gonna be nice and flush and straight when I'm all done and ready to turn this into a card. Although I don't show video yet of finishing the card, here's what came out of my efforts when it was all said and done. Make sure to check back for the next video so you can see how I got there. Hey, thanks for hanging out with me today. I'd like to invite you to join the community by subscribing, and don't forget to hit the notification bell so you'll know when my next video is posted and ready to watch. See you soon!